So this is the case when n is divisible by 2 and I'm getting 0 as remainder. render, and here if I just save this program, and here I'm writing else. So if this is not the case, number is on right. And here let me just save this program as part 1 and let me compile it and execute it. Let me show you what is the output over here. Enter a number. So I am entering 4. Number is given. Let me check another numbers. So here if I am entering 5, number is odd. What if I am entering negative number? What if I am entering say 0? So whenever you are dividing 0 with 2, remainder will be 0 itself. Okay, so I have told you that for the remainder function, if I am dividing a number with the number higher than that, then the remainder is the number itself. Say, if I am dividing 1 with 2, then the remainder is 1. If I am dividing 1 with 7, the remainder is 1. If I am dividing 2 with 7, the remainder is 2. So all of the numbers which is less than 7, and if I am dividing it with the higher number, then the number itself will be my answer. So here, that's why 0 is considered as say even number. Now let me check what will be the answer for minus numbers. So here, if I am dividing it with minus 6, the number is even. So now we can say that yes, our program works correctly. But this program contains two parts. First part is all about using if or using else option. Second part is about not using else option. So here either we can entirely eliminate if else, otherwise we can also do one thing. We can use conditional statements, say conditional operator, that is ternary operator. So first let me show you, if you don't want to just use else, you can perform it using if also. That if n modulo 2 not equal to 0. Okay, so number is odd. Let me just check if it is giving correct answer or not. So let's just save the program, compile it and run it. If I am entering 4, number is even. And again, if I am entering say 11, the number is odd. So I am getting correct answer even without using else option. The third option is you can use ternary operator. How you can use ternary operator? So you can check the condition n modulo 2, and here it should be something, okay, something like this, m modulo 2 equal to 0, then printf number is even. Printf number is odd. Here slash n, and let me just save this program, compile it and run it. If I am entering 11, the number is odd, and if I am entering some even number, that is 6, then the number is even. So I am getting correct output. So this is all about the program which will show that whether the given number is odd or even without using and with using else statements. Now let's just go to the another program. So as you can see on the screen that our next program is all about accepting three numbers from user, and then I'm going to check that which of these three number is maximum among those three. So for that I have to take three numbers from user. So I'm taking A, B, C from user and then telling user to enter three numbers. Printf enter number 1, okay, and then this, and scanf. Here you can also use scanf for accepting three numbers by at the same time, but I am using different statements for that. So here I am using something like this. So here it will be B, here it will be C, and here 1, 2, and 3. Right. Now at this moment A, B, C are having garbage value. At this moment A, B, C are having garbage value. Similarly, at this moment these are having garbage value. At this moment B and C are having garbage value. Right. But A is having value. A is having value entered by user. Please ignore the spelling. So here, okay, let me correct it. It entered by user. Here at this moment, this is the same case. Here A and B is having value entered by user and C is garbage. So I am just writing this and repeating this so that you will understand this concept. And here A, B, C are filled with user defined values. So whatever value are desired by user, these are filled at this stage. So right now, before this stage, you cannot write any expression, otherwise it will give me an error. Right. So now I want to check whether which of this number is maximum. So how among three I will decide if one number is greater than other two numbers. So I manually check each of the numbers, that if first number is greater than the second number and third number, then the first number is maximum. Right. So this is the way. I have shown you the logic in my live lecture. I have shown you that if you are writing A greater than B and then A greater than C, that means here you can see printf A is max. Right. So in my live lectures, I have shown you this logic. I am just repeating it so that you will have the knowledge. Here it will be else if, and here it will be same. If C is greater than B and if C is greater than A, that means C is max. You know, you can have any sequence. So that's why I am taking C after A. And after that, here in the default case, here it will cover, you know, B is max, right? So by default, B is max. Now let me just check. We have already performed this program. So let me compile it and run it. What is the issue? Okay, scan it. Each of them scan F. And here also scan F. This is the disadvantage of copy pasting. Now, here I am entering 1, then 20, and then 30. Then you know that C is maximum. So I am getting correct answer. But here I will not get correct answer if each of these values are similar. So in that case, I can add some other value that I'll show you at the end of this lecture. But if I don't want to write this logic, then there are some other logic that we can perform. First, I'm checking if A is greater than B. Right? First, I'm checking if A is greater than B. And here I'm writing else. So, what does this mean here? If this condition is true, that means A is greater than B. So that means I know that A is greater than B. So that means A is max or C is max. Because I know in between A and B, A is maximum. Now A can be maximum or C can be even greater than A. So C can also be maximum. So at this stage I can decide these two cases. Either A is maximum or C is maximum, because I don't know anything about C. But I am confirmed that B is not maximum if this condition is true. And if this condition is false, then the control goes to this else, and that means B is greater than A. If this condition false, that means, or I can also say greater than or equal to. So if this goes to else, that means B is not equal to or less than A. That means B is greater than A. Then only it will come to this else part. So if control comes here, that means B is greater than A, and so I know be maximum. So either this condition is true or this condition is true. Both of this condition cannot be true at the same time, right? So B is greater than A. So B can be max or C can be max, because I don't know anything about C right now. So I am from three choices of maximum number, I am having now two choices of maximum number, right? Now inside this, again I am checking it using nested if, that if A is also greater than or equal to C. I hope you guys understand that what I am doing. Here I have already checked that A is greater than B. If this condition is true, then only it come to this part. So when the control comes over here, that means this condition is already true. So I know A is greater than B. Now again A is also greater than C. That means A is max. I hope you guys are understanding this. So here printf A is max. Why? Because first condition is also true and second condition is also true. So that's why now I can decide that A is maximum. Suppose A is maximum than B, but this inside this condition is false. That means A is not maximum than C. In that case, I can say that printf C is max, or you can also say A and C are equal, or C is max, because in both of the cases, okay, C is max, right? So first, let me just show you. So at this stage, if this condition is true, that means A is greater than B and A is greater than C. That's why A is maximum. But if this condition falls, so it will come to here, and that means A is not greater than. This means A is not greater than equal to C. That means C is max, because A is smaller than C, and we know that B is already smaller than A, so C is max. Don't confuse with this logic. Try to see this video repeatedly, then you will understand this logic. So now after this, I know that if I am comparing A and B and C, what will be the answer. But here, when this condition is false, that means if this condition falls, the control comes over here. So when I'm coming here, I know that A is not, at this stage, A is not greater than or equal to B. So I know this thing, that means A is less than B. So now I have to check that if B is greater than C or not. So I already know that A is less than B. So I'm checking if B, what is the comparison between B and C. If B is greater than C, then B is greater than A also and C also. That's why you can also do equal to over here. So that's why I can write printf slash n B is max. Right, so this is because I already know that at this stage A is not less, at this stage A is less than B, because it's in else, and also this condition is true. That means B is greater than C. That means B is greater than or equal to each of them, and that's why B is maximum. What if this condition is false? If this condition is false, that means A is less than B, but B is also less than C. So at that time I can write something as C is maximum, right? So this is the another logic that you can use with your program. So now let me just execute this, save it, compile it and execute it now, so that I can check if I'm entering 1, 20 and 30, then it is giving me C is maximum, which is correct answer. Let me execute it again. What if I'm entering all the numbers as similar numbers? So A is maximum. Now it is giving me wrong answer, because here at any option I have not written a case where each of the numbers are similar. So I can also add a condition for such program. I can all add a condition if A equal to B and B equal to C. First I am going to check this condition, right? Or I can check if A equal to B, right? You can also write this condition. One student in lab lecture asked me this question, that what if each of the numbers are same or two of the numbers are same, at that time I can use this. So I can also modify the code like this, you know. Now I am checking if b equal to equal to c, then printf all numbers are same. Okay, so if a equal to equal to b and also b equal to equal to c, I can say that all numbers are same. If this is not the case, then that means a equal to equal to b, but b is equal to b equal to equal to, b is not equal to c. Or I can write let me make it more optimized by using and over here, b equal to equal to c, then your printf all of them are equal or same, right? Now this is the homework program for you guys, that what if only two of them are equal. So let me just save this program, compile it and run it. You can see I'm entering 1 1 1, then all of them are equal, but c is max is printed. So this should not be happened, because you know it is happening for each cases. So here I'm writing this entire thing inside else. So I hope you guys understand. If you understand the previous logic of this, then you don't need to understand this. This is some extra knowledge I'm just giving you. So this is an extra bracket or what? Okay, so here it will start from this else, and okay, one extra bracket for else. So let me just save this program. Now if I'm entering 1 1 1, then all of them are equal. So it was executing for each of this code. You can see this code over here, you can see this code over here, and perform your program by just pausing this video by yourself and understand the logic. I have tried to add all of the comment over here. Still, if you have any doubt, you can comment below the comment section and ask me. I'll just reply you there. If you have any doubt, you can ask. Okay, so this is all about the second practical. Now we will head into our third practical and the last practical of this video. After that, there will be another video for these practicals. So I hope you enjoy this class, and you are enjoying this class, and let's just complete the third example. So as you can see the aim over here, our third practical is all about finding the grade of student. That if the percentage is greater than equal to 70, the grade of student will be A. If the percentage is in between 60 to 70, that means grade is B. If the percentage is 50 to 60, that means grade C. And if this percentage is low, less than 50, that the student acquire half of the marks, then that means it's having grade F, right? So you can arrange this grade according to you. The program is not important, its logic is important, right? So we will perform this program only if we use else if. Why? Because these are having four cases, and to cover this four case I need at least one if, one else and two else if. So how can we perform this program? So let me just start with marks. So first student will enter a marks, and I'm telling student to enter a marks, so that's why I'm writing enter marks. Now scanf here percentage D marks can be float also, so it will be convenient if I'm using float, right? And here I can use percentage marks, right? After that, what will be done? So first condition is, if this marks or say percentage is greater than 70, that means grade A. So what I'm writing, if marks greater than 70, that means make sure that you have not put any semicolon after if else does not contain semicolons, right? So here I will print slash and congratulations, you have, we used to get this kind of messages, right, on our social media and something like that. So you have obtained grade A. Okay, so if marks is greater than 17, then this will be the case. Else if now we are having range of 60 to 70, that means my marks will be less than 70, less than or equal to 70, or greater than or equal to 60. Right. So for that I am writing, if marks is greater than 60 and we have to put and. Now think of it, whether we have to put and or not. Which logical operator should be used over here? See, I am dealing with range, so it should be and, because marks must be in between this range. If I am writing marks greater than 60 or marks greater than 70, then if one or even the one of the condition is true and another is false, it will execute this exam, this printf. How? If marks is say 100, then this condition is true, right? So it will not go. If I am doing all over here, then one condition is true, so the entire else if will be true. So this is wrong. So that's why I have to write and. So marks must be greater than 60 and must be less than or equal to 70. Here it will be else if. Okay. And at the end I am writing printf say / and, good work done, but you can improve to get the best. Right. You have achieved marks or say grade B. Okay, so this is the statement if the marks is in between this range. What is the other range? Else if marks, now this is easier, right? If marks greater than 50 and marks less than or equal to 60, then you can write good work done, but you can improve and you have got grade C. Here at last, what is the case if marks is less than? So else I don't need to write else as I do not need to write as marks less than 50 over here. I don't need to write, this is wrong syntax. By default, marks, if this is above are not the case, by default the else will be executed, that is marks less than 50. So here I am entering / and, better luck next time. Okay, right. So grade is F. Right. So this is the case. Now one may ask, I hope you have this question in your mind, that what if I have entered say 105? Bahut alvitre students hote, right? So likhte hai aisa kuch ki that marks is 105. What if marks is 105? That means marks range should be in between 100 to 0. We cannot write anything beyond 0 or anything after 100. So this is the correct program, but the good programmer is one who covers all the test cases. So this is the correct case. If I just save this program, compile it and run it, and if I'm entering say 6, then better luck next time, you have failed this exam. If I am entering say 77, that means congratulations, you have obtained grade A. So I am doing good. But what if some student is entering the marks like 111? Congratulations, you have obtained grade A. Why? Because 1111 is greater than 70. That's why for each of those numbers which is greater than 70, even if it is 1 lakh, it will give me this message, which is, technically incorrect. So we have to, if we want to further program it, I can use if marks is less than 0 and or you know or and using or. So if anyone is entering a mark which is less than 0, then it is not correct. And if anyone is entering marks greater than 100, this is also not the correct marks. So here I am writing, what I am writing? Printf enter valid marks. Okay, and in the, so if this is the case, why I have written or over here? Because if any of this condition is true, I want to print this. If marks is less than 0, I want to I want to print this. If marks is greater than 100, I want to print this. So this is the case, and here inside else I am going to cut this entire code and paste it inside and save this program. So if you want to see the entire code, then it is over here. Float marks, here you can see the entire code. Now let me just save this program, compile it and run it. If I'm entering 1, I'm getting, better luck next time. If I'm entering say 77, congratulations, you have obtained grade A. And what if I'm entering some invalid value, 111, enter valid marks. Okay, so now your program is correct, even though you have written a code which is I have written previously, it is correct, but this is good code. Okay, so you can also find some variants of this code, because I'm not saying one program can be done with with using so many other logics. So you can find your own logic as well, and you can verify it with me by just by just commenting below the comment section. Or you can also ask me personally. I hope you enjoy this class, and we are going to cover the practicals in our next video. So stay tuned with the second part. Thank you so much.